Hello, welcome back to my channel Vision India. Today I am going to show you how to find out the all possible mixed strategy Nash equilibrium by just looking at a pair of matrix. So here you can see in this example, in this pair of matrix we have two players available. The player 1 and the player 2. The player 1 is having two actions, the B and S, and the player 2 is having three actions, B, S and X. And the payoff values are given. Okay. Now the question is how to find all possible mixed strategy Nash equilibrium. Okay. So first of all, we need to find out the all possible combinations which we can make for a mixed strategy. Okay. So here we have player 1, which is having two actions, the B and S, and player 2, which is having three actions, B, S and X. Okay. So first of all, we will make all possible combinations that denotes the mixed strategies. Okay. So let's say the player 1 is taking B and player 2 is taking B, S and X. So this can be the mixed strategy from the side of player 2. But here in this case the player 1 is having a pure strategy because he is taking only one action. He is having only one option. Okay, now the another strategy can be like this. The B, S and X for 2 and S for player 1. So player 1 is having pure strategy and player 2 is having mixed strategy here. Next, we can have B, S and BSX. So in this combination both are having the mixed strategy. You can see the player 1 is having two possible actions. Out of this this subset he can choose any one action, and from this subset the BSX the player 2 can choose any one randomly. Now what can we have other combinations like BS and BS, BS and BX, BS and SX. So these are also the mixed strategies. The BS here the mixed strategy for player 1, BS here is the strategy for player 2. Here BS is the strategy for player 1, BX is the strategy for player 2, BS is the strategy for player 1 and SX is the strategy for player 2. Okay. Now we can have some more combinations possible like B and BS, B, BX, B, SX. Okay. So in these three combinations the player 1 is having pure strategy and player 2 is having mixed strategy. Now some other combinations we have the S, BS, S, BX, S and SX. Okay. So these are the total possible combinations for the mixed strategies. Okay. Remaining combinations will be belong to the pure strategies only, like B, 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 S, B, X, S, B, S, S, and S, x. So these are the pure strategies. Why? Because both the player is having the pure strategies. But in the previous one, you can see here, these all are the mixed strategies, because at least one player is having the mixed strategy here. But here, both the player is having the pure strategy. So we will not count this combination in the mixed strategy. So these are the combinations for pure strategies. So we will not solve these combinations. Okay. So we will take one by one each and every combination and check whether this combination is eligible for the mixed strategy equilibrium or not. Okay. So the first combination here is B and BSX. B and the BSX. Okay. So this is the first combination, and we will check for this. So player 1 is taking B and player 2 is taking BSX. We know for a mixed strategy equilibrium, some conditions need to be satisfied. What are the conditions that need to be satisfied for the equilibrium? The first condition is that because the player 2 is choosing randomly among BSS X, BS and X, means what? The payoff of BS and X is same. That's why he is choosing randomly. So the condition is the payoff of B should be equal to payoff of S and should be equal to payoff of X. When the other player is taking what? B. When other player is taking the action of B. So we will check the payoff matrix. So player 2 is taking B, S and X. Sorry. So the payoff of B, S and X should be same for the player 2 when the player 1 is taking B. Okay. So here we have the payoff 2 for the player 2 for the B, 0 for the 0 for S and 1 for X. Okay. You can see here all three values are different. The 2, 0 and 1. Or all three values are different. So here, so payoff of B is 2 and payoff of S is 0 and payoff of X is 1. And these all three are unequal. Okay. Means what? This combination is not eligible for mixed strategy equilibrium. Okay. So we will check for some other combination. So far we have checked for this combination, the first combination, the B and the BSX. Okay, and this is not a mixed strategy equilibrium. Now we will check for this combination, S and BSX. Okay. So here the player 1 is taking S and player 2 is taking B, S and X. We know for a mixed strategy equilibrium, the payoff of B, S and X should be same, because here player 2 is choosing randomly any one action among B, S and X, right? Means what? The payoff of B is equal to payoff of S equal to payoff of X. when other player means the player 1 takes the action of S. Okay, so we will check using the payoff matrix. So other player is taking S. Okay, and the payoff of B is 0, payoff of S is 4, and payoff of X is 3. So 0, 4, 3. Okay. So here we have got 0, 4, and 3. And all these three are unequal, and means the condition is not satisfying here. So we can say that this combination is not eligible for mixed strategy equilibrium. Okay, now we will check for some other combinations. Okay, so next combination here is BS and BSX. So player 1 is taking BS and player 2 is taking BSX. Player 1 is taking BS and player 2 is taking BSX. So for a mixed strategy equilibrium for player 2, the payoff of B should be equal to payoff of S and equal to payoff of X, because the player 2 will choose randomly a one action from BS and X, right? So the payoff of B should be equal to payoff of S should be equal to payoff of X when other player is taking what? The B comma S. When other player is taking the action B comma S, means the player 1 also can take one action, can choose one action from B and S randomly. Okay, so here I am assume here we assume that P is the probability P that player 1 chooses action B. And okay, so here we assume that P is the probability that player 1 chooses action B, and Q is the probability that player 2 chooses action B. Now we try to calculate the payoff of B, S and X and check whether these three payoff is equal or not. Okay, so we check using the payoff matrix. So we know that player 1 chooses B with probability P and player 2 chooses B with probability of Q. Okay, now what would be the payoff of B when other player is taking B comma S? So we know the payoff for B when other player is taking B is 2, and we know the probability for 2 is what? The P. And the payoff B for player 2 will be 0 when other player is taking s. We know the probability of this value. The probability for this value is 1 minus p, right? So the total payoff of b will be what? 2p plus 1 minus p into 0. So total payoff will be 2p. Okay. So here, payoff of b equal to 2p. Now we calculate payoff of s. Now again we check the payoff matrix. Now the payoff for s, we need to check this column. Okay, why this column? Because the player 2 is taking s and the player 1 is taking b and s. Can take b or s both. Okay, so we need to check this column. We know the probability for this value is p and probability for this value is 1 minus p. So total payoff for s is what? 4 into 1 minus p. Okay. So 4 into 1 minus p, that is 4 minus 4p. Now we will calculate the payoff for x. We need to check in this column because we know the other player is taking b comma s. Okay, so here you can see by just looking at this payoff matrix. So payoff for x is 1 for player 2 and payoff for x for player 2 is 3 when other player takes s. We know the probability for b is p, means the probability for 1 is p and probability for 3 is 1 minus p. So total payoff is what? P plus 1 minus p into 3. P plus 1 minus p into 3. So total payoff is what? Total three minus 2p. Okay. Now, as per this condition, the payoff of b should be equal to payoff of s, right? So we will equate these two equations. So 2p will become equal to 4 minus 4p. Now 4p will move to that side. So it will become 6p and 6p equal to 4, right? And p equal to 2 by 3. Now we will put this 2 by 3 in all these three equations and check whether these three values are equal or not. So if I put here 2 by 3, so we will get 4 by 3. Now if I put 2 by 3 in this equation, we will get 4 by 3. Now if I put this 2 by 3 in this equation, we will get 4 by 3, 9, so we will get 5 by 3. So you can see here, all three are not equal. Means what? This combination is not eligible for the mixed strategy equilibrium. So again, this combination is also not a mixed strategy equilibrium. Now we will check for this combination BS, BS. Okay. So here player 1 is taking b comma s and player 2 is also taking b comma s. We know the condition that need to be satisfied for the mixed strategy equilibrium. So what condition need to be satisfied here? First, the payoff of b should be equal to payoff of s. Why? Because the player 2 can take any action from b and s randomly. Okay, means what? The payoff of b and s should be same. But in this subset, we have not included the action x. Means what? The payoff of x should be less and equal to the payoff of b and s. So here the payoff of x should be less than equal to payoff of b and s. Okay, so this condition need to be satisfied for the mixed strategy equilibrium for the player 2. Now again we will make use of the payoff matrix to check whether this condition is satisfying or not. Okay, again we will consider that the p is the probability that player 1 takes b and q is the probability that player 2 takes b. Okay, now we check the payoff matrix for the equality. So you can see here that payoff b for player 2 when other player is taking b comma s is 2 comma 0, right? So we know the probability for b is p. So when the other player takes b with probability p, so he will get the payoff of 2. Means the probability for the value 2 is p, and probability for this 0 value is 1 minus p. So total payoff b for player 2 will be 2p. So here the payoff b will be 2p. Now we calculate the payoff of s. So we need to check in this column. We know the other players can take b and s, either he can take b or s. We know the probability for b is p and probability for s is 1 minus p. Okay, means what? The probability for this 0 value is p and probability for this 4 is 1 minus p. So total payoff for s for player 2 is 4 into 1 minus p. So total payoff is 4 minus 4p. Next we calculate the payoff of x. So we need to check in this column. We know the probability for this value 1 is p and probability for this value 3 is 1 minus p. So total is p plus 1 minus p into 3. P plus 1 minus p into 3. Now as per this condition the payoff of b and s should be same, right? So we will equate these two equations. So again we will get 2p equal to 4 minus 4p. Now we will get p equal to 2 by 3. Now we will put the 2 by 3 all in all three equations and check whether this condition is satisfying or not. So we will get 4 by 3. Again here we will get 4 by 3. And here we will get 5 by 3. So you can see here these two are same, but this one should be the less than the payoff of b and s, right? But here this value is greater than the payoff of b and s, right? Means what? This combination is also not a mixed strategy equilibrium, not eligible for the mixed strategy equilibrium. Why? Because the payoff of x is greater than the payoff of s and the b. So again this combination is also not a mixed strategy equilibrium. Now we will check for the another combination, bs and bx. Player 1 is taking BS and player 2 is taking bx. Okay. Now, we know the condition that need to be satisfied here. The payoff of B should be equal to payoff of X, but the payoff of S should be less than the payoff of B and X, because we have excluded S from this subset. Means what? The payoff of S should be less than equal to B and X. So again, we assume that P is the probability. That player 1 takes B and Q is the probability that player 2 takes B. Now again we calculate payoff when other player is taking B comma S. Okay, we need to use the payoff matrix again. So payoff for B will be 2 comma 0, right? So here 2 and here 0. The we know the probability for this value is P, and probability for this value is 1 minus P. The total payoff will be 2P. Now payoff for X will be 1 and 3. So probability for this value 1 is P, and probability for this value is 1 minus P. So total payoff is 1 minus P into 3. Okay. Now the payoff of S will be 0 and 4. Probability for this value is P, probability for this value is 1 minus P. So 4 into 1 minus P. Means 4 minus 4p. Now again we will equate these two equations, okay, because as but the condition payoff of B should be equal to payoff of X. So 2p is equal to p plus 3 minus 3p. Okay, so here we will get the 4p equal to 3. So p is equal to 3 by 4. Now we will put the value of P in all these three equations of B, S and X. So we will get here 3 by 2. Again here we will get 3 by 2. And here we will get 4. Here we will get 1. Means here we have got 1.5, here we have got 1.5, and here we have got 1. So you can see again this condition is not satisfying. So this here we can see the condition is satisfying. Why? Because the payoff of B is equal to payoff of X, both are equal, and this payoff of 1 is less than the payoff of B and X. Okay. So from the side of player 2, the condition is satisfying. Okay. Now here we know from the side of player 1, the payoff of B should be equal to payoff of S when other player is taking B comma X. So we need to calculate the payoff of B and payoff of X. So we need to check the payoff matrix. Now, payoff of B for player 1 will be 4, 0 and 0, right? 4, 0 and 0. But we know the player 2 is taking only b comma x, b comma x. So we will not consider this, the payoff for s. Okay, we will consider only this value and this value. So we know the probability for 4 is q and probability for 0 will be 1 minus q. And the probability for this value will be 0 because the player is not going to take this action. So probability for this action is 0. Probability for this action is q and probability for this action is 1 minus q. So the probability for 4 is q, probability for this 0 is 1 minus q and probability for this 0 is 0. So total payoff is, total payoff of b for player 1 is 4q. Now we will calculate payoff s for player 1 when other player is taking b comma x. So again we will check the payoff matrix. So we need to calculate the payoff for s for player 1. So we need to check in this row, but we know we will not consider this payoff. Why? Because the player 2 will not take the action s. We know the probability for s is 0. Okay, so we need to consider only this value and this value, 0 and 1. We know the probability for this value is q and probability for this value is 1 minus q. So total payoff is 1 minus q. We know that these two values should be same. So 4q equal to 1 minus q. So we will get 5q equal to 1 and q equal to 1 by 5. Okay. So we have got the value for p and q both. Now we calculate the strategy. The strategy is what? The probability for the actions. Okay. So we know we need to calculate in a strategy alpha 2, we need to calculate what the probability for b and the probability of for s. And here in probability, sorry, strategy for player 1, strategy for player 2 will be the probability for b, probability for s and probability for x. Okay, so we know the probability for b, probability for b for player 1 is p. So here we will p, and the probability for s will be what? 1 minus p. And we already have calculated the value of p. So here the alpha 1 will be 3 by 4 comma 1 minus 3 by 4, so 1 by 4. Now here pb for this is the probability for b for player 2 is q. Okay, so this is q and this will be 0 because s is not considered in this subset, and the probability for x is 1 minus q. Okay, so here we will get q is 1 by 5, 0 and 4 by 5. So this is the mixed strategy, one of the mixed strategy. Okay, now we will check for some other combinations which are left. Okay, so this one is the mixed strategy equilibrium. Okay, now we will check for this combination BS and SX. Okay, so here we know the condition that need to be satisfied here. the payoff of S should be equal to payoff of X, and the payoff of B should be less than the payoff of S and X. Why? Because we have not considered B in this subset, and the player 2 can take any action randomly between S and X. Means what? The payoff of S and X is same. Now again we consider that P is the probability that player 1 takes B, and Q is the probability that player 2 takes B. Okay. Now we calculate the payoff of S by using the payoff matrix. While looking at this payoff matrix, we can see the payoff of S for player 2 is 0 and 4. Okay. When 0, when player 1 takes B, and player 2 gets 4 when player 1 takes S. We know the probability for 0 is P, and probability for 4 is 1 minus P. So total payoff is what? 1 minus P into 4. Payoff of X, again we will check the payoff matrix. So here the player 2 will get 1 and 3, and probability for 1 is P, and probability for 3 is 1 minus P. So total payoff is P plus 1 minus P into 3. P plus 1 minus P into 3. The total is 3 minus 2P. Okay. And the payoff of B is 2 is P, and probability for this is 1 minus P. So total is 2P. Now we will get these two equations as per this condition. So 4 minus 4P equal to 3 minus 2P. So we will get 1 equal to 2p, and p is equal to 1 by 2. Okay. Now we will put this value in all these three equations, and we will get here we will get 1. Okay, from this side we can see these two payoff are same, and this payoff is less than the payoff of S and X. So condition is satisfying from this side. Now we will check from the side of player 1. We know the condition here is what? The payoff of B should be equal to payoff of S. Okay. So payoff of B is what for player 1? We will check again the payoff matrix. So we need to check this column, and we know the player 2 is taking B comma, sorry, the player 2 is taking S comma X. Okay, So we will check only these two values, this and sorry, this value and this value only. Okay. So I'm considering that the probability for S is R for player 2. So the value will be what? So 0 into R and 0 into 1 minus R. So total payoff will be what? The 0. Right? Because both the values are 0, right? So both the values are 0. So the payoff of B for player 1 will be 0. So here the payoff of B equal to 0. Now we will calculate the payoff of S. So we need to check this row, and in this row we will check only these two box only. Why? Because the other player is taking S comma X. So the payoff for this value is 2, payoff for this box is 1. We know the probability for this 2 is R, because I have assumed that the probability for this S is R. Okay, so total payoff will be what? Here the 2R and value for this, sorry, the probability for this value will be 1 minus R. Okay, so total payoff will be what? The 2R plus 1 minus R. So total we will get, R plus 1. So you can see here the value of R will always be positive, right? Always be positive. So we can see that the payoff of S is greater than the payoff of B. Means what? This condition is not satisfying. So we can say that this combination is not eligible for the mixed strategy equilibrium. So again we will check for some other combinations. Okay, so this combination is not a mixed strategy equilibrium. Okay, now we need to check these combinations which are left. So you can see here the player 1 is taking B and player 2 is taking B comma S, right? So B and the B S, right? So the player 1 is taking B and this the player 2 is taking B comma S. Okay, so you can see here the hair payoff is 2 and hair payoff is 0. So both are unequal, right? So this is also not a mixed strategy equilibrium. Now we will check for this combination. So player 1 is taking B and player 2 is taking B comma X. So what condition need to be satisfied here? The payoff of B and X should be same for player 2, right? When other player is taking B. So you can see here when player 1 is taking B and player 2 is taking B comma X. So here the payoff is 2 and here payoff for X is 1. So both are unequal. This is 2, this is 1. Both are unequal. So again this is not a mixed strategy equilibrium. Now we will check for this combination. The B, player 1 is taking B and player 2 is taking S comma X. So player 1 is taking B and player 2 is taking S comma X. So here the payoff for player 2, the payoff of S for player 2 is 0 and payoff of X for player 2 is 1. Both are unequal. Again the condition is not satisfying. So this is also not a mixed strategy equilibrium. Now we will check for this combination S comma S and B comma S. So we need to check in this row because the player 1 is taking S and player 2 is taking B comma S. So here the payoff of B for player 2 is 0 and payoff of X S for player 2 is 4. So both are unequal. So again this is also not a mixed strategy equilibrium. Now we will check for this combination the S and B comma X. Again we need to check in this row because the player 1 is taking S and the player 2 is taking B comma X. So we need to check this value and this value, and both are unequal. So again this is also not a mixed strategy equilibrium. Now we have last combination S and S comma X. So we need to check in this row because the player 1 is taking S, and we need to check these two values 4 and 3. Why? Because the player 2 is taking S and X. So here we have one value is 4 and another value is 3. So both are unequal. Again this combination is also not a mixed strategy equilibrium. So we have only one possible mixed strategy in this numerical. We have only one possible mixed strategy, which is BS and BX. Okay, and we have calculated the strategy for both the players alpha 1 and alpha 2. Alpha 1 we have calculated and alpha 2 we have calculated, which is 3/4 and 1/4 for the player 1. This is the strategy of player 1 and this is the strategy for player 2. So we have only in this numerical we have only one possible mixed strategy. Thank you.